I think the concept of what we do in the shadows that Taika and Jermaine conceived is just brilliant, you know, because what they've done obviously is take, you know, like the most mundane domestic Wellington flat setting and then turn those flatmates into vampires.
This is bullshit.
Three, four, don't sing if you want to live long. They have no use for your song. You're dead, you're dead, you're dead. You're dead and out of this world. You're dead and out of this world.
Hi, my name's Jackie Van Beek, and I'm an actor, writer, and director. I was an actor in the original What We Do in the Shadows movie. My character was called Jackie, weirdly enough. It was quite spooky.
Ah, Jackie, welcome.
Hello.
Come in.
And then, yeah, I've had some involvement with the different spin-offs of the show. I direct on the TV series Wellington Paranormal, which is a lot of fun.
Are you alright? I guess that's a no.
And I went over and directed a couple of episodes of the What We Do in the Shadows, the US version on FX, which was great fun.
Cash or card?
Credit.
You cannot pay with that.
I'm so sorry.
Did you just throw a coin at me?
Yes.
Sir, you can't be throwing ancient coins at me.
Just yeah, Mo?
The credit card.
Stab this man.
And then I was invited to do this, a kind of a reimagining of a fictional sequel. And I got the call and they were like, come down and be part of it. Second Unit is an immersive theatre show where they get hundreds of people coming through every night, but you've got staggered like start times. And so the audience are endowed as extras for a fictional kind of reimagining of a filming of a sequel of What We Do in the Shadows. There are lots of different, you know, nooks and crannies and rooms and experiences for them to explore within that kind of What We Do in the Shadows world.
Get that amateur off my set immediately!
Which one?
That one's there. It's the cape on.
I mean, it's been so successful internationally, the original film and then the spin-offs that Jermaine and Taika have created as well. And I think that's to do with sticking very closely to that really New Zealand Kiwi tone. People are really responding to Kiwi comedy at the moment. I think it's something to do with its warmth. Like, there's a lot of warmth in Kiwi comedy. We're all quite deadpan. Where people used to find that maybe awkward, now suddenly they're finding it charming. And I think, you know, any success here is such a great kind of shot in the arm for other creative people here, you know, like Jermaine and Brett with Flight of the Conchords and a whole bunch of us, you know, of course, would think, oh, maybe we can do that one day. And the way television and film now, it's such a kind of, everything's so kind of international and with the internet and all of these different platforms, we're actually able to work from home a bit more and still tell New Zealand stories or tell things in a New Zealand way. I think back in the day there was that expectation of you try and, you know, learn some skills in New Zealand and then you go offshore and try and make stuff over there. Now I think we can tell stories from anywhere and hopefully we're all still telling New Zealand stories or there's a New Zealand flavour, you know, even if it's not New Zealand content.